Among the many activities you can enjoy with NX Studio, Nikon's image adjustment software, are cropping photos to emphasize the main subject, adjusting exposure to brighten dark photographs, and using picture controls to radically alter the impression your photos create. The adjusted photos and videos can be quickly and easily posted to social media directly from NX Studio. In this video, Saito Katsunori, a professional photographer, guides you through the basics of NX Studio using these five tools. Hi, I'm Saito Katsunori, a professional photographer. Today, I'll use some sample photos to guide you through the basics of using NX Studio. Let me introduce you to the photographers who took the sample photos.
Hi, I'm Shiho. I got interested in photos recently when I started using Instagram. Good to meet you.
Hi, I'm Emoto Takuya. I generally work as an actor or model, so I'm in pictures a lot, but I got interested in taking them too. And so I've started photography as a hobby. Good to meet you.
Good to be here. Now, let's get started. First, let's import your pictures into NX Studio. First, I'll connect the camera and computer using a USB cable. After launching NX Studio, I'll click the Import button here in the top left corner of the window. As you can see, that launches Nikon Transfer 2. Click Primary Destination. Now we'll choose a Primary Destination folder here. First, click the pull-down menu. At the bottom of the menu, click Browse. We'll be saving the pictures to the desktop, so we'll click the desktop folder here. Now we'll click Create New Folder and name the new folder. Let's name the folder Nikon.
Excuse me?
Yes?
Are you saying you have to choose a destination before importing photos?
No, but I recommend you do, because giving folders easy to understand names and saving pictures in easy to remember locations makes them easier to find later on.
Oh, I see. Thanks.
Right. Now I click OK. Then start transfer. And transfer is done. As you can see here, the pictures have been copied to the folder we chose earlier. Okay, now I'd like to try editing this picture Shiho took.
Please do. This one I took of my friend's dog. Really, I would have liked for the dog to be closer. This picture feels kind of half-baked.
Right. So you'd like more of this lovable dog in the frame, right? This is when I'd suggest using NX Studio's crop tool. First, click Adjust Composition in the Adjustments palette. That'll display these options here, where you'll click Crop. You'll see the Crop tool icon. Click it. The cursor will change like this. You can click anywhere in the frame and drag to select a crop. The default is Free Crop, which lets you freely choose a crop with any aspect ratio. You can also click this pull-down menu and choose from a variety of fixed aspect ratios, like, say, 1:1 or 16 to 9. In this case, we want to crop the picture to its original aspect ratio. So we'll pick the last option in the pull-down menu. That changes the crop. We can then move it or drag the corners to resize it. Once we've got the crop we want, we'll click Proceed. That crops the picture like this.
So, are we making the selected area bigger?
Think of it more as getting rid of the bits you don't need. Digital cameras these days have high pixel counts and high resolution, so your pictures will look good even when cropped.
So if you're taking pictures knowing you'll be editing them later, you should choose as big a size as possible?
Exactly. Okay, let's try cropping another picture. We want these owls to be our focus. So, let's try free crop. We'll click the crop icon and choose a crop that nicely frames the owls. Once we've got the crop we want, we'll click Proceed to crop the picture. Okay, I guess we can move on to the next picture.
Yes, please. When I took this one, I was at Enoshima, and I thought, wow, the sunset is really pretty. It was a handheld shot, and it's a little crooked because I had trouble leveling the camera.
It's true that landscape photos can look weird if they're not level, so this is one we'll straighten. First, click Adjust Composition in the Adjustments palette. Select Straighten in the Tool list. Click this icon here. Move the cursor to the horizon's left edge. Click here and drag right, following the horizon. After a short distance, release the mouse button. This instantly levels the picture. Okay, let's try straightening another picture. So, how do we straighten a picture like this, where we can't see the horizon? The first step is to click the Show Grid button at the bottom of the window. This displays a grid of horizontal and vertical lines. Using the grid as a guide, we'll straighten the picture by dragging the slider in the Straighten tool. We'll keep an eye on the picture and adjust it until it looks more or less straight. We'll let go of the slider when the picture looks about right. Okay, let's compare it with how it looked before. We can see the unedited version by unchecking this box. You can see that the picture is now straighter. Okay, let's edit our next picture.
This is a portrait I took with my friend acting as a model.
It's beautiful, but the face is dark. Let's see if we can brighten it a little more. We'll start by clicking Basic Edit Palettes in the Adjustments palette, and then the Adjust Brightness and Color tool here, which displays these controls. First, the clothes and the background seem a bit overexposed, so we'll adjust them with the Highlight Protection slider. The other part, the shadows, will brighten using the shadow protection slider. That looks a lot better. All that remains is for us to try raising saturation a bit. Okay, let's compare it with how it looked before. We can see the unedited version by unchecking this box here. How's that?
Wow, what a difference just by adjusting the balance of light and dark.
We were also able to improve your subject's complexion by increasing the saturation. Brightness and saturation are correlated, so you should try adjusting saturation after you adjust brightness. Okay, let's try editing another picture. Here we have a bottle with fruit in it, but the foreground is a little dark. That and the colors are dull. First, we'll brighten shadows using the shadow protection slider in the Adjust Brightness and Color tool. Then we'll increase saturation using the saturation slider to make the colors a little more vivid. Finally, the picture is slightly lacking in contrast, so we'll raise contrast just a little. Okay, let's compare it with how it looked before. How's that? It looks vivid and really quite delicious. Now, let's move on to our next picture. This time, we'll be using picture controls to bring out the colors. You can only adjust picture controls when editing raw photos. Taking pictures in raw format gives you more choices during editing.
So are you saying I should always take pictures in raw format?
There's no question that raw pictures are perfect for editing, but the files are also large and awkward to handle. Plus, they can be viewed only with special software. So it's best to choose a format, either JPEG or RAW, according to how the pictures will be used.
Ah, got it. Thanks.
Okay. Let's do some editing. First, click Picture Control, which you'll find in the Adjustments palette under Basic Edit Palettes. The picture control in effect when you first took the picture is displayed here. In this case, we'll click the pull-down menu and select Vivid. The result is colors that pop and higher contrast for a more memorable picture. Okay, now I'd like to try editing this picture. Looking at it, you can see that the faded sign has a really cool antique vibe. This time, I'd like to try using picture controls to enhance the antique feel. The picture control list contains what are known as creative picture controls. There are 20 different types. Let's try the sepia picture control. As you can see, what we get is a sepia effect with the colors washed out. Clicking this triangle displays a list of controls, one of which is an effect level slider. You can modify the picture control's overall effect by adjusting this slider. Let's try setting it to the maximum level. The result is a picture with more of a period feel. It's easy to change the atmosphere of a picture in this way. So, what did you think? In addition to the basic editing techniques I described today, NX Studio offers a variety of tools for more precise adjustments, including color control points for adjustments that affect only a selected area, and an LCH editor for editing specific colors. I described these features in another video, so give them a try after you get used to basic editing.